Hi, this is Kirk from iMazing. Today I'm going to tell you how you can transfer files and folders between your iPhone or iPad and your computer. In this video, you'll learn how to browse files stored by your productivity apps, copy files from your iOS device to your computer or from your computer to your iPhone or iPad, view items in different ways, sort files by name, date, size, or kind, and rename and delete files and folders. Unlike computers, iOS devices don't provide easy access to their file systems. In fact, most of the files on your iPhone are completely inaccessible to ensure security and privacy. To view and manage files on the go, you'll need a file manager app like GoodReader or Documents by Readle. Then, you can use iMazing to transfer your documents to that app and organize them as you see fit. Note that files you transfer to a specific app are not available to other apps because of a security feature called sandboxing. With iMazing, you can easily see which apps can receive files this way. Click the Options icon when viewing apps, then choose Only Show Sharing Enabled Apps. Launch iMazing and connect your iOS device. If you've already connected a device and it's available via Wi-Fi, you'll be able to use it without a wired connection. Select your device in the iMazing sidebar, then select Apps. Click the icon of the app you want to copy files to or from. You'll see a folder named Documents. Open the app's Documents folder. If the app is storing any files, you'll see them here. You can view these files in Icon View, List View, or Column View. When in List View, you can click a column header to sort your files by name, date created, date modified, size, or kind. To copy a file from your iPhone or iPad to your computer, select one or more files and drag them to the desktop or to a folder. You can also copy files by clicking Copy to Mac or Copy to PC. If you want to copy a file to your device, just drag it into an app's Documents folder or click Copy to Device and select a file. You can also rename, delete files, and more using the contextual menu.